himself today to be baptised. So, Ronnie, after you. We're all very much looking forward to this particular time.
It still seems strange up here. good morning, everyone. My name's Ronnie, and here's my testimony. Over the past few months, I've had the pleasure of getting to know most of you in the church, and on this special day, I thank the Lord that so many of, you, of my family and friends have come along to share in this event with us. I thank you for this opportunity to share with you all the story of how I have come to this point in my life. I basically did not come from much of a religious background. When I was young, my mum would have taken the family to the odd Christmas service. But apart from that, the only time I went to church was for weddings and funerals. My dad has been a spiritualist for as long as I can remember. And when I was younger, I did look into it, but it all kind of scared me. I found myself in the middle of a marriage breakup and feeling at rock bottom in the late 90s when I come across a book sat on the bookshelf in W.H. Smith's, written by Louise Hay, titled The Power Is Within You, published by Hay House Publications. Boy, did I wear that book out. It basically told me that if I kept on asking the universe for what I needed and believed in myself enough, the universe would give me anything I wanted. Money, love, peace, etc. So I began chanting affirmations of all the wonderful things I wanted in my life. But this didn't actually go to plan. And now I found myself surrounded by debt and now with no home. But I still stuck to the plan because I believed that I had the power within myself to get myself out of all the mess. And then in the middle of all this, back in 2000, God sent me a messenger in the form of a Christian girl who was a friend of mine. She tried to tell me about God's word, and I told her all about my word and how she was wrong and needed how she should believe in herself. Well, she actually gave me this very Bible for me on Valentine's Day in 2000, which I never read at the time. Soon after this, she married someone else, and to this day is still very happily married. God bless you, my friend, and thank you for your kind words. But at that time, I just couldn't see it. I was so blind to the Lord and the fact that his arms were open to me. Well, I remained in debt and could not settle down in any house, and things did not change much until about 18 months ago, when I was watching a lady called Doreen Virtue on YouTube from the same A House Publications I mentioned earlier. I knew that she had been making big money all over the world by selling her books and tarot and angel cards. But on this particular day, she was pleading on YouTube for everyone who had bought any of her books or cards to get rid of them and even burn them. She said how she was so sorry and asked her followers to turn to the Lord Jesus Christ. It turned out that she had made a set of Jesus cards for her publishers. And in reading the Bible and going to church as part of her research, the Lord had come to her in a vision in church and caused her to make a 180-degree turn in her life. She removed herself from A House Publishers and she had to sell her home and started to read the one-year Bible every day online. I thought that her story was fascinating, and at this point, I never had read the Bible myself. It was soon after this that I started falling for someone very special to me, and she told me that she was already seeing someone else, and I was so brokenhearted. I remember crying and praying to God in the shower for the first time ever and asking him for forgiveness and help. A week passed and I was still crying most of the day, thinking to myself that I should be over this. 2 weeks went past and I was still the same, and by the third week I thought, okay, this isn't right. I'm going to have to see a doctor about this today. It was at this moment that the Lord revealed in my heart that he was with me and he had been holding me and loving me from the day I called out to him on my knees in the shower. I shortly found myself in Aldwick Baptist Church, which was like a shining light where I just had to be. I actually think a few of you thought that I was a new door security when I first arrived. But it was the most amazing time, but it has been the most amazing time since. I confirmed my relationship with the Lord and went to the Christian men's camp last year with 2,000 men, and I went forward to show my love and commitment to Jesus. I now know just that Jesus is my Lord, my King, and my best friend. I feel his love raining down on me, like the love of my mother when I was a child, but 1,000 times more. He is interested in the small details, for example. There is a man on the railway where I work as a train driver, who has been there for years, working on the platforms. I wave to him every day I see him, and he has never waved back. So one day, I thought to myself, I would pray about it. So I prayed for God's blessings on him as I was pulling into the platform. I put my hand up and waved as usual. Then I nearly jumped out of my skin, because there he was, with the most beautiful smile, waving back at me, almost jumping up and down. I just started laughing, saying, "Lord, I love you so much. You got me that time." Soon after, it was my lunchtime, and I got out my lunchbox, which my mum had made for me, and I was still thinking about the smiling and waving man, and jokingly, I said, "Lord, you'll be feeding me olives next." Then I popped open my lunchbox, and there, on the top of my sandwiches, were 3 olives, making me burst into laughter once again. Up until then, I didn't like olives, but I do now. There have been so many other wonderful things that have happened in time since I got to know the Lord personally. I simply walk arm in arm with the Lord and just sit back and give him all my needs and worries and watch him move mountains in front of my very eyes. The Lord is truly the Prince of Peace and Love. I have given him my life and love to him freely, and he is always looking after me and protecting me day and night. He never fails to answer my prayers. I may not get what I want, but I always get what is good for me or others around me. My life is so much calmer and full of peace. In the moments when I try to do things on my own like I used to, and it all falls apart, he picks me up and forgives me again and again and shows me the way. There is a song that really expresses how I feel of what the Lord has done for me. It is a song called "Clean" by Natalie Grant. Please listen to this with me. Thank you. I'm not going yet.
With joy and destiny.
By the way, the debt and lack of security that plagued for most of my life has all been dealt with, and the Lord has blessed me with a beautiful new home. I now talk and walk with him through all the good times, and in the times of trouble, I run to him. I am guided by him, I trust him, I have faith in him. I want to obey the Lord Jesus Christ and be baptized today, to publicly thank him for his love and forgiveness and grace. I have three lovely children who I'd love to see come to know Jesus for themselves. So here is my prayer. Thank you, Father, for showing me the beauty and colour in all things that I never noticed before, like the sky and the sea and the love in people's hearts. I am a new creation in you, Jesus. And wherever, Lord, you show me your love, I want to worship you. I love you for being my Lord God, my Father, my best friend. I will walk with you until the last breath comes out of this body, until that moment that my spirit awakens in your arms. I pray that those whom I love will come to know you in a personal way as I do. Thank you, Lord Jesus. All glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Thank you, every one of you, and God bless you all.
I really like him, you know. Superb, Ronnie. Wasn't that wonderful, everybody? The courage to come and say it, but actually such sincerity. He's not making this up. This is reality for Ronnie. And I just think it's so important we hear what he says today. Really something. I think really we all get the tissues out and just dab our eyes, you know. Okay, Steve, please come up, my friend. I like Steve as well, actually. So.
Good morning, everybody. I'd like to start by saying Happy Mother's Day to everyone today. A special Happy Mother's Day to my mother-in-law, Sue, who's absolutely amazing. And also another special Happy Mother's Day to Anna, because it's her first one today with baby Elsie. So I'd like to make a point of just saying that today. So most of you probably don't know me. You may have seen my face over the last year or so. But for those of you who don't know me, my name is Steve. And I'm very lucky and honoured to be married to my amazing wife, Melissa, who I'm sure perhaps a lot of you may know more. Growing up, like Ronnie, I'd say that I didn't come from a particularly religious family. Although I was christened, that was really about it. We didn't attend church, and God, Jesus, Christianity wasn't ever spoken about in our household. But as I grew up, I feel that I was slightly different to the rest of my family, and that I had this sense of God's presence and Jesus and heaven, and there was something there that I couldn't explain. I was lucky enough as a young boy to live only a bike ride away from my local church down in Selsey, where I grew up. And one evening a week, the church would all meet up and play some games and some sports, and we'd have a drink and some snacks, and we'd all sit round, and then we'd talk about God and Jesus and the Bible. And I felt right there, and I found myself taking myself off down to this church every week and enjoying it more and more. To be honest, I wasn't very good at understanding it all, especially when it came to talking about the Bible. It was all written in a way that I couldn't make sense of it. And each time I thought I was getting somewhere, I would get all confused, and I'm pretty much still the same today. I can't quote passages from the Bible, and I can't explain many stories or any of Jesus' teaching like I'm sure many of you are able to do. But it's the same for me now as it was then, as I felt like I have a personal relationship with God. Although I didn't understand the Bible, he understood me. I spoke to him and he knew I was there. I wasn't sure how to explain he was there, but it was like I knew he was. I felt that God knew growing up that I was struggling and I was going to struggle. So I feel that he didn't wait for me to go to him. I feel that he came to me and guided me to this church for my first steps towards him. And although I didn't understand the Bible, I felt that God and I had this personal relationship, and that's where my relationship with God started here. As I grew up, I continued my relationship with God, and I'm pretty ashamed to say that I felt like I didn't need to attend the church anymore. I didn't understand the Bible anyway, and God and I had this understanding and this personal relationship, so I felt I don't need to go, I'll continue as I am. I started playing more and more sports, football, basketball, rugby, everything going I was training for and playing. And before I knew it, I'd look back and I hadn't been to this church for ages. As I say, throughout all that time growing up, I continued my relationship with God and I spoke to him. I always knew that he was there. But recently, only looking back, I would realise that I was always asking something of him. God, please protect my family and make sure that they're all safe. God, please make my dad happy and help him to have an amazing life. God, please give me strength and guidance and help me be a better person. I realise now that I was always asking for something of him, even though I wasn't giving anything back. Despite that, I felt that God never let me down, and he got me through awful times growing up. Times where I wanted to curl up in a ball and give in, as if I felt I didn't have the strength to wake up and do another day. He would always be there for me. But I still kept asking rather than giving. So my relationship with God, as I've explained, stayed like this for many years, pretty much the majority of my life, until I met my beautiful wife, Melissa. Melissa and her amazing family, who are obviously now also my amazing family, are, as I'm sure you all know, they're very involved in the church and attend regularly. So all of a sudden, things took a bit of a shift for me. Conversations about God would randomly pop up and we would sit and have a cup of tea and talk about Jesus and Christianity. And this was all new to me. It wasn't something that I'd ever experienced outside of a church setting for when I was only a child. I felt amazing. I felt proud. I felt God's power. I felt that I couldn't help but smile. And it was as if Melissa was my key to a locked door to God that I couldn't ever get back through. And with her amazing love and her amazing kindness and with her direction, it's like I've been shown my path back to God. He had never left me, but I've been too far for him to reach me. So we started attending church regularly, and two things happened that created the spark for me to be stood here and being baptized today. So the first thing is Melissa showed me a video, and it was called Everything Skip by Lifehouse. And I think we have the video so that we could possibly play it so everyone can see.
Thank you.
So when I watched this video, I couldn't believe how accurately it had described my relationship with God throughout my life. It was as if it was a personal interpretation of everything I'd experienced, being close to God at an early age and being pulled away and distanced from Him, letting things like money, work, time, stress and worry take over and keep God from me. Until meeting my wife, Melissa. Melissa showed me the way back to God and allowing me to see where I was going wrong. And like in the video, as soon as I've turned back towards the right direction and towards God, started to fight my way back towards Him, He stepped in. And I feel like He's protecting me from all these things that I'd let come between me and God, and gives me true happiness and blessing me with not only His love, but blessing me with the love of my amazing wife. In doing this journey and going through all that I've gone through, I feel now I have a relationship with God that's new, a close relationship. It's like a rebirth, a second opportunity. And it's that feeling I had as a child that drew me towards God in the first place that I was confused about and things didn't make sense. And it was all a bit blurry. But now all of a sudden it's crystal clear. The second spark for me being here today actually happened before the first one. One Sunday when we was attending church here, we'd sang a few hymns and listened to a few stories, and we stood up to sing another hymn. And the hymn is called Here I Am, Lord. And I'm sure a lot of you will know it. But for me, it was the first time that I'd heard this hymn. And it was a really weird experience for me. It was as if God was speaking directly to me himself. And I remember it really vividly. The room was a blur, and it was as if God was speaking to me throughout this song, especially in the chorus. The words are, Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. And I honestly felt like God was speaking directly to me and asking me to step forward. I felt like God was trying to say, I've been here for you in the background your whole life, listening to your prayers, guiding you, keeping you safe, being by your side, being here for you, Steve, without fail. And God done all that for me, despite all I did the whole time was ask for his help and take from him. I felt like he was saying to me, Steve, I now need help, and I need someone to help me to help others spread the word of God. And I felt in my heart, my answer to God was exactly the words in that chorus. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. Send me to help. Send me. Use me, help spread the word of God, and help to be so proud and honored to be able to do so. Send me. And being baptized today will mark for me the new beginning of living closer with God and helping him in any way that he sees that I can. Thank you for listening to my testimony.